everyone, and welcome to another Wednesday where we have our coffee break. Good afternoon to you. My name is Shai, and today, as always on Coffee Break, we discuss the things that matter to you, especially with regards to work. So today, of course, I cannot do it by myself. I'll need someone to help me out with the topic and the argument and, you know, seeing all the sides of the situation. So please let me bring in my good friend, Miss Chloe, DJ Chloe, Mom Chloe. Shai. Ano ba ba?
Hi, Shai.
Hi, Chloe. Ayan.
So, and hello to all the viewers.
There you go. Happy watching, guys. Please don't forget, by the way, to share this video to your friends. We are going to talk about, let me just give you a quick overview. We're going to be talking about work benefits. Mm-hmm. Aside from the SSS, the medical. Aside from those that are, you know, government mandated benefits, we're going to be talking about the other benefits that you may have or may not have in your workplace. So we'll be talking about that. So let me start off by asking you.
Okay.
I don't want to talk about our company. Ayaw kong i-booking kung ano man meron tayo or yung wala tayo. You guys will never know. But ito na lang. If you were to advise people or your kids, for example, what to look for in a company, would you, what they would consider more in a company rather when they would look for a job, diba? Would you rather let them focus on the company's reputation or the work benefits that the company offer? Yung sa company reputation kasi, usually it's, you know, does it mean the company has to be established na? But on the flip side, if they are established, baka naman wala masyadong benefits na makukuha. On the flip side, they may or may not be that established, but they get a lot of benefits from that company. So, where would you let them lean towards to, or what would you suggest to them?
It would be nice if they get themselves into a company that is established.
The best of both worlds.
Plus the benefits, but
yeah,
paano ba? Ang hirap. I think siguro I'd want them to be in a company that's already established. Because if we're talking about a company na okay yung work benefits, pero hindi pa ganun ka-established, baka startup company yan, ang mangyayari, mapuputol din naman yan eh. So I'd want them to be in a company na established, and at the same time, i-establish din nila yung sarili nila.
Okay. But what's your opinion about a small startup company, not yet established, they give the employees good benefits, hoping that these employees would work harder, be motivated to work harder, and make the company, you know, the kind of company that is very well known. Gets mo yun? Baka naman that's a good incentive to help make the company a lot more known.
Pwede rin naman. It really depends. Kasi I do not know, by the time they start working, I don't know what they need eh.
Aha, tama.
Ako, I'd like to think that my kids would somehow magkakaroon ng influence yung kung anong nakita nila sa akin.
Ah, there you go.
Diba? Kung paano yung tenacity mo sa trabaho, paano ba yung work ethics ng magulang ko, nakukuha natin yun eh. Diba?
So, I think also, what they see from you, what they see from your experiences, is what they'll also consider when looking for another job.
Yeah, especially if yung nakita nila is naging 2-hour advantage or for pag-aral ko sila and all, diba? Pero yung point mo rin naman na sinasabi mo na if a company gives them this and that, they might be compelled to really work hard, tas yung company lalaki and all. Aminin na natin, ang pinakamalaking motivator sa atin, pera talaga.
Totoo yan. Huwag tayong plastikan, guys.
Huwag na tayong maglukuhan.
Exactly. Sabi dito ni CJ Gunay din, yes, benefits are something that I'm looking for as an experienced worker. But for newbies, they should prioritize the experience first. How to make their CV colorful, then they jump to the next level. That's a good perspective. That's a good point of view to consider. Kasi, kaano ka natatagal sa isang kumpanya kung hindi pa talaga very well known yung company or something. And eventually, once you gather all the experience, that's when you can demand to have more benefits kasi you are a lot more experienced already. Like, you are a bigger asset to the company at that point kung sakali. Okay, thank you for your perspective, CJ. Okay, sige. How about this? Based on your past jobs, Chloe, or based on the past jobs of your other friends, for example, that you know of, did their work benefit get different from one company to the other? Let's say, sa radio, sobrang iba. At ng anong feeling nakakainggit or nakakatuwa? Ano? You don't have to mention the company mismo, ha?
Ako, natutuwa ako sa kung nasaan ako ngayon.
Of course, tayo pa ba?
Oo, oh, diba? Totoo naman. I mean, our company is not perfect. Diba? Yeah. Marami rin sa ating mga how I wish, ganito, ganito. But looking back, hindi naman ako tatagal ng 12 years with MBC kung hindi naman ako dito masaya. Diba? Ikaw rin naman siguro siya ay.
Okay. Eh. Exactly. You were with us 2014. 2013, tama? If I'm not mistaken.
Oh, 2013. So, masaya ako ngayon. So, if I were to compare from before, ay, mas gusto ko na yung mga benefits ko ngayon or yung mga nakukuha ko. It may not be a lot, but it's, substantial.
Yun. Okay. Sige, sige. Baga. So, in our case, it goes by our satisfaction of what we receive. Kasi I'm sure for a lot of people, what we get is so, so little for them. You know, they want more kinds of this, more of that, etc., etc. So, tayo happy na tayo dito. We get enough to live our lives.
Yeah. You know?
Pero for others,
they're not inside the organization kasi. There are other things naman kasi that you will also have to consider na we also enjoy.
Yeah, yeah.
By being an employee of our company. To some people, pag sinabi mo talaga, ah, ganun lang yung ano, it's not appealing.
Exactly. You know what I mean? A lot of people turn off yung ganyan.
Pero syempre, hindi nila alam yung the other things that we do here that gives us, you know, a decent life. Oh, yun na lang.
I don't want to share to you our benefits and whatever. We're not gonna do that here. But I do want to share one thing. Star City privileges dati.
Sana nga may balik. Oo.
Unfortunately, wala na ngayon for obvious reason, di ba? But I remember being so excited when I got the regular position. And then they were joking na, at meron ka na rin ganito, ganyan sa Star City. Ako, joke ba to? Hindi, totoo daw, seryoso. Oh really? I get this and all that. So
yeah.
I was really happy about that. But anyway, sana nga ibalik, diba? But ito, let me just share to you guys also, kasi the industry that me and Chloe live in is quite small, diba? But let me share to you other examples. Like for example, accountants. Sobrang dami kong friends accountants. So you know, there's a lot in all kinds of companies. And there's also a lot of accounting firms, diba? So they basically have the same thing going on with them for my friends. Pero napapansin ko talaga na there are some companies that are so well-known but they give so little benefits to their employees. They get paid well, yes, benefits, parang kawawa sila. While others naman, they're like in a so-so kind of good company, pero hindi ganun kakilala. But they are spoiled.
So generous.
That's the term I would use. My friends who work there are quite spoiled when you think about it.
Mm-mm.
And that's the reason why those friends there are continuing to stay. Kahit hindi ganun kakilala yung company, but they're choosing to stay there. Compared to the ones here on the other side na kilala nga, but for lack of a better term, unhappy sila.
Totoo. May experience na ako sa ganyan. A multi-billion peso company talaga.
Uh-huh.
It's a local company, pero yung benefits at saka yung salary grade ng mga empleyado talaga ay maluluha ka every payday. Pero ang laki-laki ng kumpanya. Diba?
Yes!
And, yun. In addition to what you said kanina that we have the Star City privilege, I'm very proud to say, I don't need to elaborate, but you know, our company, we have the best medical benefit.
True. Guys, so happy.
Yon, the best medical. na sana ganun magbago, diba?
And I think everyone deserves to have really good medical benefits.
True. Kahit okay lang, ganyan yung sweldo mo, mababa or something. Pero kung may ganun ka naman, you won't realize it na mag-ganun kaganda siya until kailanganin mo
you
siya.
You get hospitalized?
Yes.
You're
rushed to the
ER? Or your family members? Oh my goodness, guys.
True.
Yung, kasi kapag hindi mo pa na-experience, but you keep putting... you keep putting money into medical coverage, or you know, because usually, naman for a lot of companies, happy eh, or you get you put a percentage, and then the company puts a percentage, diba? So, a lot of times, maraming magre-reklamo ng ano ba yan? Hindi ko naman kailangan yung medical, bawas ng bawas sa akin sa sahod ko. Guys, still, you will not realize how important medical is until you actually need it. But on that note, Chloe, some people are asking here, ano ba ibang benefits ang pwede? Kasi siguro they've never experienced. You know, benefits in their company. Siguro they get the basic ones, but nothing more than that. So, there's 14th month pay, guys. Swerte talaga yung company mo.
If the company's doing really good.
Oo.
Diba? 14.
There is extra vacation days. Kasi for us, I think we are 15 days lang. I mean, the Philippines in general.
14 days, I think. Sick leaves, which is mandated na kaniyata.
Oo,
I wish sana magkaroon ng additional.
Like 1 month.
Oo. I wish sana magkaroon ng additional na leaves para sa mga single parent.
Oo, you know, mga ganun like po, di ba?
And I hope makonsider din yung mga housing benefits dyan.
Yes. And also, other companies also have benefits for parents who are not yet married. Na, kasi usually, yung guy ang lugi, di ba? Ganun. Yung father ang lugi, madalas. Mm-hmm. Pero, lalo na kasi hindi sila kasal or something.
Yeah.
So, there are other companies who are like, no, don't worry, even if you're not married, even if you're just living together, whatever, cover, we will give you like a month leave, for example.
Paternity leave.
Oo, ganun. So, those are some of the examples. And then, there are also some benefits where, well, a friend of mine, they can buy stocks from the company, they can own stocks from the company, rather, after a few years, which is really good, especially if your company is well-known, diba? So, those are some of the examples of benefits that you might not even know exist because you know, you've only lived in that small bubble of your workplace. Parang ganun.
True.
So, my point here is, guys, there are a lot of companies that offer quite a lot more. Hindi lang talaga siguro natin alam. But yeah, ito. We do know that we want benefits, Chloe. Sure naman yan. We want everyone to have the best work experience ever. Pero why or how do you think that these work benefits are important to an employee? What would you say? How important are work benefits to an employee?
Very, very important. How important? Sobra.
Very.
Very. Because when I was starting... there were companies na napasukan ko na walang benefits. Merong walang SSS, merong walang PhilHealth, meron namang may Medicard pero 500 pesos lang yata pag na-emergency kay mga ganun, 'di ba? It's very very important talaga. And even if, you know, they take a bit of it out of our salary, okay lang naman. It's something na kahit binabayaran mo and hindi mo paggamit yung benefits, gusto ko na nandyan pa rin siya because, you know, it's parang paano ba? It's hard to need it and not have it and then have it. Tama ba? Am I saying it right? O parehas tayo sa bow today?
Wait, sandali. It's better to have it
and not need it than need it and not have it.
Yes, exactly. There you go.
So,
I'd rather just have it laying around there, but you know that in case something happens, it's there for you, diba?
Yeah.
Another, I think one other reason why I think it's quite important for employees is actually also beneficial for the employer. Because that would make your employees, especially the good ones, really want to stay with you. Really want to keep staying with you, despite, let's say, toxic working conditions, for example. Pero bawing-bawi naman sa benefits. I'm not saying that just because you have a lot of benefits, okay na, forgiven as toxicity.
Kahit stress na stress ka.
Pero it just adds to the loyalty of the employees to the company. Ganun. So, if a company, if you are an employer right now and you feel like you are at defense of wanting to give your employee more, this mm-hmm. is a really good sign for you to just give it to them so they can stay longer with you, so they would be continuously loyal to you.
tama, loyalty. Oh. Importante mm-hmm. din yan. Rather than, you know, palagi aalis yung empleyado mo and then there you go again, you're gonna train new ones again. Although sabi naman nila, mm-hmm. they'd rather train new ones than to deal with yung mga empleyado na matitigas na rin ang ulo or may mga sumay na rin. Reklamador.
Tama. Oo. Ay, nako. But again, guys, huwag kayong ganun na. Reklamador lagi. But anyway,
yeah.
So we've mentioned earlier the different kinds of benefits here and there, but if you were to say, choose five, if you were to pick five, three or five, three na lang, parang na-pressure ako eh. Three benefits that would really matter, aside from the government-mandated ones, what would you say are those three that are quite important for an employee?
Three benefits other than the mandated, like the SSS to yes. fail health. Yon, the medical is number one. I also mm-hmm. wish that companies would consider giving their employees life insurance.
Yes, that's life smart. Insurance. Yeah, I didn't think of that. Okay.
Oh, diba? Importante yon eh. Yung it's like paying for your peace of mind that you know yes. your kids would be able to continue at least living their lives even if you're gone. Kasi mahirap pag breadwinner mm-hmm. nawala. So that's medical mm-hmm. life insurance. Housing. Gusto ko talaga yung housing. Sana magkaroon ng gano'n na, you know,
yung aside from the usual loan lang ah. Ah, okay.
May pag-ibig naman kasi. Pero, I've known of companies na meron silang kinikreate na sarili nilang village.
Okay.
Na nandun yung ibang employees, yung mga gusto na kumuha doon. Eh, kung ayaw mo naman, then you can get yours and then find somewhere else na lugar, pero mas magandang yeah. meron ka, diba? Yun, my top three.
Okay. Pero tama talaga, pinaka-important dyan, medical talaga, diba? Like, for some
medical
reason.
Medical insurance yun.
Yes, medical. Medical dental, kasama na yan dyan.
Yes.
Medical dental and all, everything that covers your body's health, diba? Yan, kasama mm-hmm. yan for me. Pangalawa.
Yung life insurance.
You got me curious about life insurance, pero napapaisip ako kung ano pa ba. Pero, a really good retirement plan siguro from the company.
How about car plan?
As much as I feel like excited ako sa thought ng car plan, pero feel ko hindi siya sa top ng priority list ko. But yes, kung pwede, oo. But not part of my top priority. Sa akin is, yun nga yung medical and then a really good pension pay or retirement plan or something that the company would offer. So at least, you know, for sure, I would stay with them for a very, 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 very long time, diba? And then maybe, ano pa ba? Shucks, napapaisip ako tuloy.
Groceries.
Ano ba bonuses?
Shai, monthly groceries.
Gusto ko yun. Why not? Pwede rin naman.
Alam mo, yung dati ko station noon sa probinsya, meron kaming ganyan. 2,500 yata a month. Although, it's like parang credit doon sa grocery. Pero it yeah. helps. O monthly bigas. Kahit siyang sakong
exactly.
bigas.
Exactly. Pwede rin. Uy, oo.
Super appreciate ko yan.
Nakakatulong. Sobrang laking tulong talaga niyan. You know, no matter how high you are in the system or if you're just blue-collared, sobrang laki ng tulong talaga ng isang sako ng bigas per month.
That is true.
Hello, Jen MBC. Baka naman.
Kahit kalating sakong bigas. Oh.
Okay na sa amin yun. Nah, I'm kidding. But my third would probably be with regards to education for the kids. Parang
I'd rather they extend na lang the medical benefits to the family, kahit 50%. But the education, kasi I think it's more of us parents' obligation.
Ah, sabagay. Diba? Sabagay.
Oh, pero kung may mga companies na nagbibigay ng scholarship sa
they do.
Mga anak, di ba? Oh, why not?
They do. Parang yung company ng pamangkin ko, parang if you're with a company for 15 years, you can, basta like they have scholarships for kids of parents who were with the company for 15 years and above, parang ganoon something.
Oh, ang ganda.
So syempre, hindi naman siya buong tuition covered, pero they give a huge chunk per semester. Parang ganun. Mm-hmm. At syempre, the usual...
Oh, malaking bagay yun. That's a big help.
Diba? Nakakatuwa. Sorry, may mga nag-message dito hindi ko nabasa ng maayos. Sabi dito...
Oh, isang group of companies daw dyan, ng malaking mall, nagbibigay ng scholarship.
Ayun, oo. Oh, actually, diba sila pa, not just for their employees, but also... for, you know, everyone else want to apply, diba? Mga ganon. Nakatuwa, mm-hmm. nakatuwa na we are hearing other kinds of benefits as well from different experiences from you guys. So, thank you for sharing that. Pero ayun. So, I guess it really goes to show that everyone just wants... But ito na lang pala. But at the end of the day, what would you advise them to look for nga na would a person rather go to a company that is well-known or just... a company na okay lang pero maganda naman yung benefits?
I don't know. Ang hirap na. Ang hirap.
Sige, now that we're in the pandemic. Okay. Yun na lang. Now that we're in the middle of a pandemic.
I think hanapin nila yung stable na kumpanya.
Ah, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because the benefits kasi, kahit napakaganda ng benefits, if the company is not stable, wala eh. Kasama kang mawawalan.
Agree.
This is coming from someone na nanggaling na rin sa mga startup na with all the high hopes that we will conquer the market and all with our marketing plan and... You know what I mean?
I know. I do.
Yon.
But yeah, I just realized it now. As in literal, nagka-epiphany ako na, oh nga no, pandemic. I wouldn't suggest for someone to take a risk. If you're starting off and you have if you have a safety
wala
net, kang that's
choice.
Fine.
Wala nag-hire sa'yo, go.
Kung wala kang safety net, I would really advise you to go for the safe company, which is a known company, which is a stable one.
Yes.
That, you know, if the pandemic is still gonna last another year, hopefully not, but if you do stay there, mas safe ka.
Yeah.
As so, if for sure you're going to receive something every month pa rin.
correct. May not be the same, but at least it's, you know, continuously, meron ka, may pang chicha ka, may pagkain ka. Yun.
Kaya yung mga friends ko who, kasi nga ako, I usually play safe talaga eh. I'm not aggressive with my risk eh. But when one of my friends asked me, should I just start my own business and quit the job I have right now?
Pares or, naman tayo siya eh. I'm not that risk taker, lalo na sa negosyo.
Oo, diba? So, alam mo yung, I don't feel like I should be the one to tell them this kasi I'm not a risk taker, but I keep telling them na huwag ka muna mag-resign.
Yeah,
kasi
if you can do both.
Kasi ang hirap maghanap ka maging successful. Yes, oo, of course, diba? But if your business is not yet a certainty to put food at the table, huwag muna and enjoy the little that you could get from your company now. At least meron. Diba?
Ang hirap kasi sa mga, you know, I don't have anything against them kung yun naman talaga yung passion nila na magnegosyo. But you're not sure if business will always run.
Oo. Again, diba? Hindi kami tamang tao na makapagbigay ng advice sa inyo, guys. Ha? We are playing safe all the time.
Empleyado kami.
Exactly.
But if you can, you know, do both. You're employed. At the same time, you have another source of cash flow. O bakit hindi?
Oo. Diba? Pero eventually, if you guys decide to become your own employee, you know, you become your own boss, and then you do have people under you, make sure also that you could give them as much benefits as you could afford.
Yes. Okay. So that they stay loyal to you. Mm-hmm. They would want to be working for you for the rest of their lives.
So, yun lang, guys. Again, this is the topic of work benefits for people who are wondering whether what they get right now is the same as every other market. And also, actually, it's a good idea pala to scout or just silipan mo lang kung ano yung mga natatanggap ng ibang kumpanya or ng ibang empleyado that is at your level.
Mm-hmm. Tama.
Kasi baka naman pala sobrang lugi nang nakukuha mo sa company mo. Mahal na mahal mo, pero lugi ka pala, di ba?
Oo.
Especially if ano ka... Yeah.
Pero kung ano, like for example, minimum wage ka naman, you have the basics, like SSS, just make sure na hinuhulog, ha? So, kung mabulog ka, kailangan mo mag-loan, hindi pala humulog, hindi naghulog, maraming ganon.
Uh-huh.
At least doon, hindi ka lugi.
So there you go, guys. This is another topic that's getting me anxious sometimes. Parang, oh, are we getting enough? Or are my friends getting enough? And what about the people who ask me, what should they be expecting or whatever? Parang dami nga talaga nating gusto, diba? But we can't get it all. Just make sure that you feel that you're well compensated in the company that you're working for right now. At least sana feel mo fair ka. Fair nangyayari. Ayun lang po. Well, I'm sorry I couldn't be the one to read all of the comments right now, guys. Chloe, mayroon mo nagko-comment at gusto mong basahin kasi
actually, I need cannot. To refresh Hold on.
Pareho ba tayong mahina ang net ngayon?
Oo. Cheche Perez for Onda. Miss ko kayong pakinggan sa radio. Okay.
Lagi naman kami na sa radyo, guys.
Yeah. Baka siguro nasa ibang lugar siya. Sabi niya, pag mabait ang boss, mag-stay din ang empleyado. True. Pag meron ding hindi mabait ang boss, nagsistay ang empleyado, kailangan kasi ng trabaho.
Oo. Kailangan na kailangan. No choice ka eh. Ganun, di ba?
Beng Lizardo says, when your employer treats you as a family and ang sarap at saya lang po magtrabaho. Benji Girl says, if you're happy with your job, it's not a job at all. Ah, okay.
Yun. Ay, isa rin pala. Gusto ko yung term niya, family. There are some companies kasi na, although sakto lang nabibigay na benefits kasi wala naman sila masyadong malaking pera, di ba, or whatever. Pero if someone in the company gets sick, talagang inaalagaan ng boss, kino-cover ng boss ang expenses just to make sure. And that is so heartwarming. Na parang gets ko naman na hindi nila kayang magbigay ng constant monthly benefits or whatever. Pero when the employee needed their boss, talagang all out yung mga boss magtulong. Sobrang like, salute to you guys. Salute. And if you find an employee who is like that, if you could stay, if kaya mong tiisin to be there, at least you know that they are going to take care of you no matter what.
Hindi ka pa. Oo, sasaluhin ka. Ito sabi ni Emerson Pedria. Let's admit it, having a backer in the office helps a lot to get hired. Benefits are just a big part. Keep safe, Shai and Chloe. Oo nga.
Thank you so much, Emerson. That's an interesting chismis.
Yes. Maritas, pasok.
Pakaibang topic natin yung extend ko sa mga backer.
Wow, pwede. Susunod. How did you get hired?
Baka lang naman. Oo. Ayaw natin po kasama ngayon. But yeah, there we go. Thank you again, Emerson, for that thought. Okay, I think there's a few more here. Mm-hmm. CJ, yeah, he mentioned about the benefits from a certain company. Beng says, ayun nga sabi niya, when your employer treats you as family, ang sarap at saya mag-trabaho. Thank you, Che. You have been quite active in today's coffee break. And I think that is it. It's time for us to wrap things up. Thank you so much, guys, for contributing to the conversation. We do love it when you guys pitch in as well because it gives us a different perspective sometimes. And yeah, don't forget to also follow us on all of our social media accounts. We're at Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube. They're all the same, just Key and Easy Rock Manila. That includes the previous episodes of Coffee Break where we have other controversial work-related topics to talk about. And yeah, of course, we're also always on our shows. Sa mga nakakamiss na po sa amin, we also have our app. Again, it's Easy Rock. Just download that on the Google Play or the App Store. It's for free and you can listen to us here in Easy Rock Manila and all the other Easy Rock stations all over the Philippines. And yes, we are on air, Chloe, if you don't mind inviting them to listen to our programs.
Yes, of course. You can start your day with Samantha at 6 o'clock in the morning till 10. And of course, I follow next 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. And after me, it's Nick for the continuation of the show. And that's from 2 p.m. to 6. And at 6 o'clock till 10 in the evening, it's Shai. And then after that, it's all music until you wake up again with Samantha at 6 o'clock in the morning. So, yeah. That's it, pretty much about it.
So thank you so much again, everyone. We will catch you again on our next Facebook Live, which is tomorrow, if I'm not mistaken. We're going to do game day tomorrow. It's a Thursday. We are moving it to Thursday for this week once again. So for more updates, again, follow us on our social media accounts, just Key and Easy Rock Manila. And that is it. I got to go. Once again, my name is Shai.
And of course, my name is Chloe, and we are from 96.3 Easy Rock, just the right rock. Bye.
Bye, everyone.